Hello students,
today in circle lesson inside we'll see the HOTS question from problem set, and the first HOTS question is question number 2nd, 22, and this is the HOTS question. And what is the question we will see at first term, what is the question? So in question, in figure two circles intersect each other at point S and R. So here are two circles I have drawn already. This is the bigger one and this is a smaller one. And they intersect at each other at point S and this is point R. They are intersecting each other at point S and R. Their common tangent PQ. So here it is the common tangent P and Q. So this is the common tangent PQ. Touches the circle at point P and Q. Means this PQ is there. It touches the circle at point P and at point Q. Okay. And we have to prove that PRQ. Means we have to draw the angle PRQ and PSQ. So first of all here it is PRQ and PSQ. I will PRQ. So this is my triangle. This is this angle PRQ. Means which angle? This angle is PRQ. PRQ means this angle. I shown with the pink color, that angle PRQ plus angle PSQ. So first of all PSQ we have to take. So we have to do the construction here for that. And I will show the construction with different color. So here it is my construction. Okay. So I have to show that this angle PRQ plus angle PSQ. This angle PRQ plus angle PSQ is equals to 180. That I have to show. Okay. So for that I will first of all I had done the construction. So here I will write draw shown. What is the construction I had done? Draw SP. S R is here, sorry, here it is R. Draw sig S R. Okay, so this is my construction. So first of all if you see here PSR, angle PSR, this angle PSR plus is equal to, means here I will write angle, proof is here, this is my construction, this is my proof. So angle PSR is equals to angle RPQ. Angle RPQ. If you see here PSR, this angle PSR is equal to angle RPQ. Okay. The measure of these two angles is same. Which two angles I told you? This PSR means this angle and P RPQ. Okay. Why? Because they inscribe the same arc. Okay. PR, they inscribe the same arc. So PSR also inscribe PR. And PRPQ, this angle also inscribe arc PR. Okay. So this is the first statement. That is my first statement. And reason behind it is the tangent secant theorem. Okay. One more that here we have to show that angle RSQ. This RSQ, this angle RSQ is equal to RQP. This angle RQP. This angle's measure is also same. And reason behind it is also same. Angle RSQ equals to angle RQP because they inscribe the same arc, this one. RQ. So RQ. QB. Okay, and this is the second statement, and for reason for both of them is the by tangent secant theorem. By tangent secant theorem. Okay, now what I have to do in triangle PQR, this PRQ, in triangle PRQ, as you know that sum of all angles is equals to what? 180 degree. So in triangle PRQ, angle RPQ, RPQ plus angle PRQ plus angle RQB equals to 180 degree. Okay, and the reason behind it is the what? Sum of all angles of a triangle is equals to 180. So here we will write sum of all angles of a triangle. Reason is sum of all angles of triangle. Now, as you just written here, these all angles PRQ plus RQP plus QPR, these all angles measure is equal to 180. Here we wrote that PSQ is equal to RPQ. PSQ is equal to RPQ. So what I will do here, this PRQ, this I will write as it is. Okay, and next RPQ, this RPQ I will replace with PSR. PSR, this I will replace with RPQ, I will replace with PSR, and RQP means this angle I will replace with, see here, this and this, these two angles, that is RPQ and QR, RQP, these two I will angles I will replace with this angles. So the next step of my proof is the what? RPQ I have to replace with, here it is RPQ, I will replace with the PSR, angle PSR plus angle, this is PRQ plus angle RQP, here it is RQP, so I will replace with RSQ is equals to 180 degree. Now what I got it here, this angle RPQ, PSR, PSR, this angle, plus PRQ, PRQ means PRQ, and plus angle RSQ is equal to what I got it here, 180. Now if you see here, PSR plus RSQ means these two angles, sum of these two angles is equals to how much? It is there PSQ. So I will replace this angle. So first of all I will write PRQ, angle PRQ plus into bracket I will write now PSR, angle PSR plus angle RSQ, angle RSQ is equals to how much? 180 degree. Okay, now if you see in the figure, PSR means PSR, this angle is PSR, plus angle RSQ, this angle is equals to how much? 180 degree. So what I will, this both I will replace with the sum of PSR plus RSQ means PSQ. So I will replace this angle, angle PRQ plus angle, these both I will replace with PSQ. PSQ is equals to 180 degree, and that is my proof. That is my proof, and here the reason behind it is the angle addition postulate. Okay, so in this way we can show that what, these two, sum of this angle and this angle, I think I told you this PSR, but not PSR, PSQ, these two angles measure is 180. Okay, if the two circles intersect each other, okay, and they have a common tangent, that common secant, and common tangent, then the angles form, that is PRQ and PSQ is equals to how much? It is there, its measure is 180 degree. Now, next question we will see, question number 23. Question number 23, it is also a Hertz question. So here it is a question. In figure, two circle intersect at point M and N. Two circles intersect at point M and N. Okay. And secant drawn through M and N. Secant drawn from M and N. M and N intersect the circle. Intersect the circle at point which R, S and PQ. R, S and PQ respectively. P, these are the points respectively. Okay, and we have to prove that that is SQ is parallel to, means SQ is parallel to PR, that we have to prove. And for that, figure is given. So here it is the figure. This is my first circle and this is another one. I will draw small one. Okay. So this is my, otherwise I will draw the bigger one here. So this is my second. This is point M. And that is N. Okay. And this is afterwards what I have to show. I have draw the common secant for this both. So this is my secant passing from point M. And this is another secant passing from point N. Okay. And I have to show that these two are parallel to each other. These two are parallel to each other. This first term which this is the secant passing from point M, intersect this circle at point R and it intersect this point at S, and here it is from point secant passing from point N touches this circle at point P, and here it is at point Q. So I have to show that this this and this is the I have to show that SQ is parallel to this RP. SQ is parallel to RP. Okay. So, first of all, I will do the construction. First of all, I will draw the MN. This is a figure. It is given in the textbook. So, this is point. This is MN. So, I will write the proof of it. So, first of all, I will write the construction. What I had done? Draw MN. Draw seg M N. Okay, so MN I had drawn here. Now, first of all, if you see in the figure, you will notice that this is the third circle. So we will refer this figure and I will write the proof this side. So draw segment. So its proof I will write here. So if you see here in my figure, you will notice that this MRNP, MRPN, these two, this is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, this is cyclic and angle MNQ, this is angle MNQ is exterior angle. This is exterior angle for this cyclic quadrilateral MRPN. So I will write it here. In figure, quadrilateral MRPN, MRPN is cyclic. It is cyclic and angle MNQ, MNQ is exterior angle. Okay, is exterior angle. Okay, if it is a exterior angle, MNQ, if it is exterior angle, then its measure is equals to MRP, okay, and it is the corollary of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, exterior angle is there, it is, what happens, its measure is equals to adjacent angle, which is there, MNP, okay, its opposite angle is the, which, MRQ, and this MRQ and MNQ, this MRP and MNQ, these two angles measure is same. That is our what's corollary. So I will write it here. Here, therefore, angle MNQ, MNQ is equals to angle MRP, MRP, and reason behind it is the corollary of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, now quadrilateral, and this is my statement number one. This is my statement number one. Okay, now next, same way MNQS is also cyclic. Quadrilateral MNQS is cyclic. Okay, and as you know that MNQ plus angle MSQ, these two's measure is equal to, if it is cyclic, its measure is equals to how much? Its measure is 180. So I will write here angle MNQ plus angle MSQ is equals to how much? 180 degree. Okay, and reason behind it is the theorem of cyclic quadrilateral. Theorem of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, now what I will do here, here I shown that MNQ is equal to MRP, and here I have told you that MNQ is equal to MRP. Now, and here in second statement inside, what I shown to you that MNQ plus MSQ is equals to 180. Now what I will do, this MNQ I will replace with MNQ, I will replace with MRP. So here I will write, instead of MNQ, I will write here MRP. Angle MRP plus angle MSQ is equals to 180 degree. What I shown to you, these two angles measure is equal to how much I shown to you? 180. Now if you see here, this is RP and this is SP. And these two are, if RS is its transversal, if RS is its transversal, then PRS and PRQ, these two angles measure is 180, and these two angles are interior angles of a, what, parallel, interior angles by the of two lines by making by transversal RS. And if this is 180, then this PR is equal to SP on the what, it is the what, interior angles test of the parallel line. By interior angle test of parallel line, we can show that this PR is equal to S cube. So I will replace this here 180 degree. So here this is the one. No, this is third statement. And this we replace with the, instead of that you write here from one. Okay, from this we can we replace angle here. Now, if you see here, therefore, MRP. This MRP, I will just rename it SRP. Angle SRP plus angle. This RSQ, I will write MSQ instead of RSQ. So, I will replace with RSQ is equals to 180 degree. Okay, but these two are the interior angles. Okay. And here therefore we write but angle SRP and angle RSQ are interior angles made by transversal RS, okay, transversal RS on lines which are RP and SQ, RP and SQ, okay, these two lines are there, here interior angles are there, and therefore what we have to prove that this RP is equal to SR, therefore say SQ or RP is parallel to SEG SR. Okay, and reason behind it is the interior test of parallel line. Interior angle test for parallel lines. Okay, so in this way we can show that what these two lines are. If these are MN is a common secant in for these two triangles, and if you draw the lines passing from MN, secants passing from point M and from point N, okay, which are those RS and PQ, then these lines which are RQ, RP and SQ, these are what happens parallel to each other. So for that, what we have shown that this is a cyclic quadrilateral, therefore angle MNQ and MRP, they are equal in measure. Then this is also MSQ and this is also cyclic, and these opposite angles are there, 180 degrees, means they are supplementary, and you just replace MNQ with MRP, then you will get here these two angles is equals major is equal to 180, and according to interior test of parallel lines we can do that these two lines are parallel to each other. Okay, so in that way we will show this theorem. So today we will stop here only, and remaining that hot question we will see in our next lecture. Okay, thank you.